I've been working on IPv6 technology since 1993, 25 years now. And for the last 25 years, we have said it's going to be there, universally deployed in the next 2 years. Well, apparently we're not there yet. So we have been looking in ICANN Office of the CTO at data of penetration of IPv6 worldwide, not just globally, but country by country. And we took a list of 150 countries that have at least 1 million people in there. And we looked at data coming from APNIC, from Jeff Houston, to see how many people are capable of using IPv6. And the result of the study is that you have about 30, 50 countries where you see an uptake of IPv6 that is visible. And those users are able to use it from maybe 5 to 20 or 40, 60% of them. You also have 100 countries where nobody shows up on the radar. You have essentially 0% of users capable of using this technology. So there's a divide here between the two. But the story gets a little bit deeper when you look country by country on those who have deployed IPv6. And you realize that sometimes there's a plateau effect where a service provider, maybe two, join the party and deploy IPv6. So you see an impulse and the statistic goes to maybe 20, 30%, 40%. And it's followed by a plateau. And this is not necessarily the better news to get in on the direction for a full IPv6 deployment. Now, the question is, what does it mean to the internet to stay in a mode where you have IPv4 and IPv6 for a long protracted period of time? That's not what we envisioned 25 years ago. We thought it would be a much more rapid transition. So understanding the consequences of that is something that is of interest to us. Now we have this data, what can we do with that? Well, the first thing is to dig it a bit deeper and try to understand why in some countries some service providers are doing it and some are not, and what are the socio-economical factors that are behind this. The other thing to do is to understand the consequences of this protracted period of time where we'll have both IPv4 and IPv6, and what does it mean on the security and stability of the internet. So more further research is needed, and we would like to take this opportunity here at APRICOT to engage in a conversation about this.